even in 2018, he's still a God who can meet the needs of those who call upon his name. And then I also began to reflect a little bit about this word press, and I thought that Paul was telling us to get serious about life, because we don't know what will happen to us as we go on this journey of faith. And in order to get serious, Paul reminds us that he had to give up some things in order to get closer to Jesus Christ. And I want to tell us, Paul was not a poor man before he came to Christ. Paul was wealthy. As a matter of fact, Paul sat on the Sanhedrin council that made rules and regulations for all of the citizens surrounding him. So he wasn't a poor man. He was a rich leader. But he said, I gave up a lot so that I may get to know Jesus for myself. The question is, what's blocking our view of seeing Jesus? What's keeping us from getting more closer to Jesus? And I want us to search ourselves. Be reminded of the word that tells us to take up everything and throw them aside that so easily beset us. In other words, we don't want anything holding us back as we go toward this new year. We want to run with patience. We want to run with faith. We want to get to know Jesus in a better way. The Bible tells us as we draw nigh unto God, he will draw nigh unto us. If you never needed the Lord before, we sure do need him right now. You should be an old song. They don't sing much no more. That every once in a while, the old folk in my church where I grew up had a deacon. He would say, Lord, this is a needy time. Lord, this is a needy time. Look at what's going on in our world. This is a needy time. And I thank God I know who holds tomorrow. And I know who's holding my hand. But as we go through life, Paul is encouraging us to get serious. Paul is saying, so many words, I have to get serious with this thing. You know, we got to realize that life is short. We think, some of us think that this world is our home. But I've got news for you. One of these days, six strong men will carry us to the cemetery and lay our souls at rest. The question is, do you have a home? And glory. See, that's the real question. I don't care how much money we have on this side. It cannot pay a deposit on what God has for us. So Paul understood, I got to give up something. I can't put my riches before God. I can't put my wealth before God. I can't put my position before God. Because I need it. There's going to come a time when my time is going to expire on earth. But I need to know that I've got a building, not me. Paul is encouraging the church. You're going to have some challenges, but don't throw away your faith. Keep the faith. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. You're going to have sickness in your body. Paul said, I prayed three times about the throne that is in my flesh. And God didn't remove it, but he said, my grace is sufficient for you. And my strength is made perfect in the time of weakness. So I want to encourage us today, don't give up, but hold on a little while longer. See what the end is going to be. When I thought about the word press, Brother Bongo, I thought about that P telling us that we need to be prayed up. Tell somebody, if you're going to make it through the presses of life, you got to learn to pray for yourself. It's good to have two or three people praying for you. It's good to call on the pastor, the bishop, and the elder, and the deacon to pray for you. But you got to learn how to pray for yourself. You got to learn when you can't get nobody on the other end of your telephone that you can look up and dial 111. Run for the phone. and say, all I stress, my hands to thee, Lord, all the help I know, if thou withdraw thyself from me, Lord, where shall I go? Anybody here had to press their way with prayer. And you know what prayer can do. I know for myself that prayer can heal the sick. I know for myself that prayer can open doors that no man can hold, that closed doors that no man can open. I know that prayer can make your enemy your footstool. I know that prayer can cause God to turn stone to flesh, lay on the midnight hour. I know that prayer can cry out a weeping eye. Anybody here know what prayer can do? Sometimes how the enemy comes and antagonizes us.
Yes.
If he messed with Jesus, what do you think he's going to do with you? Amen. Because the word is true. Jesus says, Satan came to steal, kill, and destroy. But I came that you may have life and life more abundantly. So when I thought about that armor, I thought about resisting. Jesus did when he met Jesus in the wilderness and told Jesus, if you be the Son of God, turn these stones into bread. But Jesus declared, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Anybody ever been messed with by the devil, the old slew foot devil? He comes to us in all forms. He comes to us in the middle of the church service. He comes to us in our family structure. He comes to us through the one we love. But you gotta learn to look to the hill from which comes your help. And you gotta say, I'm oppressed. In the church where I grew up, I remember when things began to look difficult in the community. We had one of the church mothers, she would get up and sing a song that I don't hear much anymore. I'm pressing on! Anybody know that song? Yeah. The upward way! New heights are giving me every day. Still praying as I'm orbit bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. You gotta ask the Lord to plant your feet on higher ground. If you wanna be lifted up a little higher in 2018, you gotta say, Lord, I'm pressing on! I'm not gonna let my friends stop me. I'm not gonna let my job stop me. I'm not gonna let money stop me. I'm not gonna let my health stop me. I'm gonna press on anyway.
Yes.
To God be the glory.
Yes.
For the great things he has done. And then when I thought about pressing on, I thought about the E in the word press, Minister Bonds. And I told myself, I gotta stay engaged in the word of God. The Bible says, study to show thyself approved unto God. Workmen that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. That tells me I gotta learn the word of God. I gotta hide it in my heart. Oh, so that I might not sin against him. But I come to find out when challenges come in life, when the word of God is already in me, I go to the source that gives me strength. Because the word says that his word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. So when things get a little difficult, anybody ever had difficult moments, I tell myself what the word says. But my God shall surprise.
Jesus. All about your trouble. Quit walking around whining about how sick you are. Quit walking around whining about how unloved you look. But tell your neighbor and tell yourself, I got a God who loves me. He makes a way out of no way. I got a God who heals me. Don't you run on and see what the end is going to be. So you got to learn to stand.
Press on!